Hello everyone, welcome back to Sew Gurney Sew and our part two of our Tulip Pink Bag. So we are on to the part we have liner all made up here. I do have the opening right there. I got it all nice and ironed and pinched together there to hold that in place, and so we know where the opening is at. So we're going to go ahead and work on our front and back panels first. So I've took these in the last one. You'll know that it was 8 inches by 6 inches. I took them and cut a half an inch off of both of them to ensure that they're number one equal in size, but number two so we don't have no fraying edges that we're working with on this as well. So we have our pockets, one for each side. So I'm going to lift mine up above the dinosaurs and attach it there. So we're going to go ahead, and we know that this is 12 inches across here. So we're going to find the middle of that and then the middle of the pocket so we can line this up to have equal spaces on both sides. So now that we know we have the middle of our placement here, and we're not going to worry about how far from the top. We're just going to eyeball that and put that where we want it. If you want to measure it out to be precise, you certainly could. So I'm going to go ahead and line that up and make sure that's even going across. And the best way you can do that is to line up your ruler with something, whether it be a line on your mat or a line on your... Okay. So we'll go ahead and pin that into place once we get that all lined up. And we're going to go ahead and get the placement of the other side on as well. And then we're just going to take that to the sewing machine, and we are going to sew a quarter inch seam all the way along that. We make sure you're back stitching to hold that seam in there. When we're done, we're going to put our straps going up the side, so you don't got to worry about having that quarter inch extra open or unstitched to sew those sides in. So we're just going to go ahead and get that sewed in, and we'll iron that open, and I'll get the other side done, and I'll meet you back here. So I have the pockets put on them now. So all I did is I stitched that down with that quarter inch seam. I flipped it over, ironed it flat, and then I went ahead and I took a top stitch just at the very edge of that. So I'm going to set that one aside, and what we're going to do now that our pockets are attached, we'll flip those up how they go. We'll line this edge just a little bit past that, so we make sure that's hidden underneath. And we want to make sure that our handle is all the way down to the bottom. That way it gets included in that bottom seam, and it gives a little more strength to that handle. And then we'll do the same with this side. And as I said, if you want to make that longer, you can make that pocket shorter. You can make it so your handles go underneath of your pocket if you'd like. This is just the way I chose. It's the easiest way to me to get it done. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to sew those all the way down. I'm only going to sew them to the top of the pocket. Then I'm going to go across and go back down and meet that. And I'm going to do that to both of them on both panels. And the reason for that is you have a seam to put in here yet. So we're going to go ahead and get them put on. I'll get them both put on and I will meet you back here. We'll start putting the shell together. We have our straps on now on both bags. So our pockets are nice and ready to go. So the next step is to put the middle in between the bags. So we'll go ahead and we'll line up one of these on each bag. And if you want to look at the design and decide where you want what, that's fine. They're kind of the same. There's not, we do got a little one there, so we'll keep this little guy over here on this one. We're just going to line those up, clip them into place. So we're just going to go ahead and we're going to put that quarter inch seam on both of them, and then we're going to run down that side with that zigzag on it. So when you're doing your zigzag stitch, you do want to lower that. So mine, I normally sew on a 1.6, 3.5. So on a zigzag, I put it down to 1 and then 2.5 for my width. So you do want to make it smaller. It tidies it up. It makes it a little bit more nicer on the inside. Although this will be covered by our liner, it just actually gives it a little more sturdiness as well. So So we're going to go ahead and we're going to get these two done. We'll iron them open, and then we'll come back and we will connect these two together. And then, of course, our final one there. So we'll have a bag just like this without the bottom in it. So we're going to go ahead and get that done, get that zigzag in there, and I will meet you back here. Okay, so we have the shell all sewn together, all four sides. And as you can see, I did the straight stitch and then the zigzag on the outside. So I was going to start putting that lining in, and I thought, well, it's going to be easier to do the bottom first. So we're going to go ahead and do that. What we're going to do for the bottom is, once again, we're going to, just like we did on the lining, we're going to line that up with that seam to that quarter inch mark. Make sure our top is nice and lined up. Okay, so we're going to start here at a quarter inch, and we're going to straight stitch all along there with a quarter inch seam up until a quarter inch away from the end. And then we'll lift our presser foot, and once again, we'll turn our fabric to go this way, and we're going to sew up to a quarter inch, and once again, turn it, and we'll keep going until we got it all the way around. Then we're going to go back around with a zigzag on the outside edge, just as we did this part. And then we're going to go ahead and get that liner attached. So I'll get this all done and I will meet you back here. I'm going to show you quick. I put a swivel hook on the end of mine. It's nice to hold chapsticks or coin purses or whatever. So it's nice to have that extra swivel hook on there. So I just took, once again, a 2-inch strip, sewed it in half, ironed that flat. And then I just threaded it through the swivel hook. And these are 1-inch swivel hooks. They do come in the kit that you get over at Ivy Bags and Things. And then you're just going to sew as close to you as you can to that swivel hook. And then to attach it, you're just going to line it up wherever you feel is right, making sure that you can get a quarter inch seam in there yet. And you're going to, I just stitched it down at probably an 1/8 inch. So we had plenty to work with when we go to stitch the rest on. Okay, now that we have our swivel hook on our bag, so there's a couple different ways that you can finish the bag off. So I'm going to show you the easiest way, where you will not need that stitching, that opening in your liner. So you can go ahead and stitch that closed or not put it there in the first place. And you're just going to put this on right side out. So you got the two wrong sides together at this point. And just line up those corners really nicely. Make sure your straps are tucked in. Okay, once you get it like this, so you got, this is the right side, this is the wrong side, this is the wrong side, this is the right side. So you got the two wrong sides together as such. Then line up your seams. And then on the inside, you're going to take the top of the bag and you're going to put it right sides together and stay a quarter inch back on each side of that seam with the end of your top of your bag. And then you're going to make sure the tops are all lined up. Put a pin in there. And the same here. You're going to make sure them seams are all lined up. Make sure it's a quarter inch in. Make sure your top's lined up. Pin that into place. And you're going to go ahead and you're going to sew that. You can do a quarter inch, you can do a 3/8 inch. I'm just going to do a quarter inch, and then I'm going to go ahead and do the zigzag over top. And then you're going to go ahead and lift your presser foot when you get a quarter inch away, pick this up, and you're just going to keep working your way all the way around your bag like that. If you want, you can actually do both ends, line up both ends ahead of time, so you know how much you have to work with on the sides. Now, when you do this, you want to make sure that you're going far enough to get that zipper, which if you go in a quarter inch, you're going to get it. So just like that. That way, when you get around one side and you go to put the other side together, you know exactly how much stretch you have for this to stretch out and line everything up as you're sewing along. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get that straight stitching on, and then we can get the clips off and get the zigzag done. At this point, you do want to open your zipper so you have a way to turn that the right way when you get it sewn up. So it's not turned the wrong way and you can't get it open. So we're going to go ahead and sew this up, and I'll bring it back and I will show you the finished product. So our bag is finished. As you can see, we got a pocket there, a pocket there. We have our hook here that we can hook on whatever we want to. The lining on the inside is fully covered. Nice short handles. Now, if you wanted to, you could also do a D-ring here and do an actual handle with the swivel hooks for it. I kind of like this one. It's nice and simple. It still looks adorable. Nice and big, actually. It's, you know, 6x12, so you got plenty of room. Would make a nice little overnight bag for kids going to slumber parties and so forth. So go ahead and let me know in the comments below, you guys, what you think of this one. As always, if you found this video useful, go ahead and give it a big thumbs up. It really helps our channel grow. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, because we'd love to have you here at Sew Granny Sew. Thanks all. Have a great day. Bye.